Good morning, sir.
Good morning, students. Students, you have studied about corrosion as an example of redox reaction in your previous class. Today, we will understand about the concept of rancidity. Students, have a look on the table. What can you see here?
Sir, I think this is butter, if I am not wrong.
And also, sir, I think the sample on the left looks a bit yellowish, and while the sample on the right, it looks like fresh.
Yes, you both are right. One sample is fresh and another sample is little bit yellowish. Now Keshav, you smell the both samples and tell me, what do you observe?
Sir, this fresh butter has a pleasant smell, while this another yellowish butter, it has a foul smell, sir.
Now, Swati, you tell me, what is your observation?
Sir, I think Keshav is right. We can see the color difference as well as the odor difference in both the samples.
Yes, you both are right. Fresh butter has uniform color and pleasant odor, whereas yellowish old butter is non-uniform colored and foul odor.
Students, can you guess the taste of the two samples?
No idea, sir.
If you taste both sample, you will find fresh butter is delicious in taste, whereas yellowish stale butter is sour in taste.
So, why there is so much difference between both the butter samples?
It is because of rancidity. In this process, when fats and oils comes in contact with air or they are heated, they undergo oxidation reaction, due to which there is change in taste, odor and color of these oils and fats. This phenomena is known as rancidity.
Sir, I was wondering, is there any way we can prevent this rancidity?
Let me explain this to you, that we have seen our daily life that oil and fat containing foods are stored in airtight containers to prevent their oxidation, and by this way we can prevent rancidity from occurring.
Oh, yes sir. Now we understood that why our mothers keep oils, pickles and other food items in airtight containers.
Yes, correct. Let us take one more example from our daily life to understand the concept of rancidity. Keshav, do you like eating wafers or chips?
Yes sir, I do. I eat them quite often.
Okay. When you buy them from market, you usually get a packet like this?
Yes sir, exactly.
Have you ever thought why these packets are filled with air?
No sir,
never thought about it.
Okay, well, let me tell you the reason behind it. Students, the gas which is filled in such packings is nitrogen, as nitrogen is inert in nature and hence it does not oxidize the oil and fat which are present in food products. Thus, it prevents the rancidity of food product stored in them. Students, have you got it?
Yes, sir.
Now, students, tell me, what have you learnt from today's session?
Sir, we have understood the concept of rancidity and the chemical changes leading to it.
Also, we have learned about the methods of preventing rancidity.
Well done, students. Let's conclude today's session here itself. Goodbye, students.
Goodbye, sir.